Hey guys, so I want to continue talking about Splinter Cell Blacklist, and this time about the co-op missions. You know, co-op is not a new thing for the Splinter Cell series, but it's actually my first time playing Splinter Cell the co-op way. I just never had anyone to play with, actually. There was that one time years ago when I played the very first co-op mission of Chaos series. And I played that with a friend for about 30 minutes, actually, but something came up, and I had to go home before I could play anymore. Conviction allowed for cooperative play, but I played through OnLive. OnLive doesn't allow for the cooperative missions, and co-op is only available for deniable ops missions. And that, I thought, was better off playing solo, because if I got discovered and set up an alarm, it was usually not because I messed up, but because my online partner did, and that was frustrating. So in that sense, you know, playing Splinter Cell Blacklist with another person, online player, it can be quite frustrating. It just almost always seems like the other player, they're always more gung-ho, trigger-happy in their playstyle than I would like them to be. I would advise into my headset, you know, what paths to take, what methods are the stealthiest, and try to communicate, only to realize that a second later, I may as well be mounting off to like a deaf, suicidal gunman. It only takes seconds for a fiercely loud gunfight to start, and then it only takes a few seconds after that to end up with a botched mission. I'll have to bear through a long loading screen once again to start the whole thing all over again. And hopefully this next time, the other player can be more of a help than of a nuisance. Mechanics in Blacklist are actually more suited to aggressively lethal playstyle than the previous Splinter Cell games. I think even more so than Conviction. When I'm playing by myself, I tend not to play that assault type of way. But for co-op, I'm actually glad Blacklist allows for a more shooterific approach, if you will. I make sure to be armed to the teeth with incendiary grenades, proximity mines, gas grenades, and the ever-trusty SC-4000 assault rifle. Splinter Cell and co-op isn't really a stealth game anymore. More like a game in which I get to be like the modern Rambo. I just have to throw all my preconceived ideas about Splinter Cell games out there, should I play, and it's actually quite fun, especially the sections in which I'm asked to eliminate all the hostiles in the area and defend against waves of incoming enemies. Those are fun playing with a friend, or just an online partner. There are segments in which being discovered results in mission failure, though. All of the extra missions with Grimm acting as liaison are total stealth missions. I like how they're designed, but played with another random online co-op partner, it can be quite maddening, so those missions I definitely recommend you play by yourself. The other player is not always at fault, though. There were times when I felt really sorry because I messed up. I felt really bad in those moments. Like, I even had some people rage quit on me afterwards. That sucks on two levels. The first obvious reason is that I would have to find another online partner and restart the mission from the very beginning. So that sucks. The second reason is this extra layer of guilt that simply would not exist if I was playing the game by myself instead. You know, this is why stealth gameplay can be such a downer to play with other people. I largely did enjoy the co-op experience I had with Splinter Cell Blacklist, but now I can say with first-hand experience that co-op is not really my preferred way of playing stealth games like Splinter Cell. Two co-op missions really stuck out to me as quite ridiculous, like Call of Duty-esque ridiculous. Splinter Cell has never been about set-piece moments, but two of the co-op missions set a new uncomfortable precedent for the series. Take for instance, Briggs' mission, Abandoned City. The final moments of that mission involves lying down near a helicopter landing zone and shooting down a wave of enemies coming towards you. It's a really scripted sequence. You're lying down on the helicopter pad, you're just shooting down enemies that are just coming at you. There's a lot of explosions, and even some slow motion sequence there. Michael Bay would be proud. Finishing this mission results in a pretty interesting story reveal, but the manner in which this action sequence and this mission are so scripted was really highly off-putting. I've read on the forums that playing this part in the hardest difficulty mode is real pain. I haven't even tried that. In the Briggs mission, Smugglers, that's what the mission is called, there's a section in which one player has to go through dark alleyways of the abandoned city, while the other player takes control of a drone, and pilots the drone and brings down a rain of missiles down to whatever the area to take down the enemies. You wouldn't know it when you're piloting the drone, but if you happen to be the other player, it's pretty chilling to actually see and hear the missiles strike the enemies near you. There's this whoosh sound, and then immediately the sound of a loud, terrifying explosion. The ground is shaking. The part of the co-op campaign, this part, made me think a lot about the devastation that drone strikes can cause. It's easy to look at the thermal screens, the black and white thermal screens of terrorist dots on the map, and then firing missiles at those white blips. But the effect is quite intense when you're actually there on the ground as the missiles whoosh and boom so close to you. I had a lot of fun with co-op campaign of Blacklist, especially when I played with someone who actually knew how to play the game and actually communicated with me. When you play Splinter Cell with someone who's serious about their experience as you are, the game experience becomes a whole new beast altogether. Chances are, though, that you'll end up being paired with someone who just wants to shoot up some baddies. There's some fun in that, sure, but you know, especially as Blacklist does give you some flexibility to play it like a shooter. But then be prepared to endure many, many frustrating moments and lots of loading screens. Cheers.